Welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar, and in this video we will learn how to create a performance meter in Microsoft Excel. As you are seeing my screen, I have created this performance meter which is connected with this data, this cell. If I will change this cell value, let's say from poor to average, then you can see this needle has been moved to the average, and similarly for good. So we can use this performance meter in our daily dashboard or any other report wherein we have to showcase the process performance or any other performance. So I have taken these three type of performance. You can take five type of performance also. So let's start how we can create this in Microsoft Excel. I'm going to add a new worksheet here, and I will create that performance meter here. Okay friends, to create that performance meter, I have to take few support. So I'm creating this support column wherein I'm taking 10%, 10% and 10% three times, and rest is 70%. So just sum of this should be 100. So three times of 10% I have taken because we have to showcase three type of performance, right? So I'll select this and I'll go to the insert. In insert, I'll go to the charts and I will insert this donut chart. Now I'll go to this chart elements and I will remove chart title and legend. Now double click on this yellow area so that it will be selected. Now we can fill this area as no fill. Now select the donut again and go to the format. So first of all, I will remove the shape outline. So I'll take shape outline as no outline. Now I will fill the color. This is the first. So I'll take it as poor. For poor, I will fill the red color. Double click here and go to the fill, and I will fill the solid color and I will take this red color. Now double click here and I will fill solid color again, but this time I will take this amber color or orange color. Double click again and this time I will take this green color. Okay, now we will rotate this donut. Basically this is not in the middle like this chart, so we have to change the angle. To changing the angle, we have to understand the calculation first. So let me show you the angle. Click here and you can see in the format data series. If this window is not opened, you can right click and go to the format data series. Here in angle of first slice, you can see currently it is zero. If I will change this angle, then you can see it is moving basically in this donut. Okay, so now we have to identify what angle we should put here. So I will tell you the calculation. We are considering the 100% perform here, right? Including the 70%, and for 100% it has a 360 degree angle. For each 10%, it will be 36 degree, right? Now we have to understand, we have to rotate this. Currently from this line, it is 30% ahead, but it should be only 15%, and 15% this side, right? So we will take only 15%, rest will be the 85%. So for 85%, for 10% it is 36 degree, for 85% it will be 36 × 8.5, which is 306. Now right click and go to the format data series, and here put the angle as 306. You can see this is in absolutely middle. Now we can remove this calculation. Okay, now select the entire chart and go to the format. Here I will remove the outline of the chart, save fill as no fill, and I'll go to the view and I will remove the grid line also. So here we will showcase our performance. here performance and I'm creating a list here, list, and I'm taking as in the list source poor, average and good. Like that. So you also can put the conditional formatting here, the same conditional formatting. Let's say Alt OD, the new rule, go to the format, all the sales that content equal to, first of all I will take poor, and for poor I'll go to the fill and I will fill the red fill, and font I'll take white for red, and new rule, this time again I'll go to the format only sale that content equal to, and I will take average, and for average I'll take fill as this orange color, and the last one which is the good, so I'll take equal to good. For this green background I'll take font color as white. Now you can see it's working. Okay, now we will create the indicator here. To creating that, first of all we will take these support cells here. So I'll put a formula: if this value is equal to, so let me tell you first, this is the 0, right, and this is 10%, this is 20%, and this is 30%. If the value is selected as poor, then where should be our needle? Needle should be in middle of the red, right? And what will be the middle of the red? Red range of the red is 0 to 10, then needle should be on 5%. Similarly, if here is average, then the needle should be in middle of the this orange block, and to keep the needle in this orange area, we have to take the range between 10 to 20, which is 15, and similarly here 25. Okay friends, so we will put this same formula, like if this value equal to poor, then it will return 5%, or if this value equal to average, then it will return 15%. If this value equal to green, then it will return 25%. Otherwise, if somebody removed the this value and nothing is here, then it should taken 0%. So we have not taken the correct spelling of average. Now check. So when it is average, it is poor, then 5% is average, then 15. If it is good, then it is again. Oh, it should be good, not green. Then it is taking 25%. Okay. Now here I will give the middle, needle size or the bit, needle bit, which is 0.5%. Now here I will take 1 minus the 100% minus sum of this. Okay. Now right click on the chart and go to the select data, and I will add a new series. The series name I will take performance, and the series value will be this I2K. Now right click on this outside donut and click on change series chart type. Here in chain series chart type, I'll select the performance series. In place of donut, I'll select this pie and click on secondary axis. Now you can see this pie chart is available. First of all, I'll select this. I'll change the angle, the same angle 306, which we have taken for donut. And now I'll go to the format and I'll take shape outline as no outline. Now double click on the this first slice and fill it as no fill. Now double click on this gray area and select as no fill. Now double click on this needle and fill as solid. Sorry, it was not selected. We can change, let's say 5% here. Now double click and we can take it as fill is as solid and black. Now again we can take is 5%. So our performance meter is ready. We just need to format this. It's working. Okay, to format this I can insert a text box. Just create a text box and put it as poor. Format shape outline as no outline, shape fill as no fill, and just keep this here. And I'll go to the home and will change the font color as white and make it bold. And just rotate this like that. Now copy this and paste here. For green area, I'll take good and just rotate this like that. And same we will put in this orange area for average. Copy and paste this here like that, average. We can also change the font color as black for average only. Okay, so friends, now we can insert a shape. We will take this oval from basic shapes and just click here. We can take the size as 0.3 and 0.3 and just keep this oval here. Now go to the shape effects and presets and take the second preset, which is preset 2. Now we will give this glass effect. To give this glass effect, I will insert a shape from basic shapes, this shape which is pi, and just click here. Sorry, change the size, press shift key and change the size accordingly. Now I will keep this here, and in fill I'll change the transparencies, few transparent, so that I can see the chart behind this pi. Now I'll pick this yellow pointer and I will remove like that, and this yellow pointer like that. So we have to adjust this like that, change the size, make sure it should be bigger than the chart. Not the chart, this poor, average and green good area. And we have to adjust this by this picking this yellow point like that. Okay, now we can remove the transparency. And now I'll go to the shape effect, and in shape effects I'll go to the preset and I will choose this preset 8. Now you can see this glass effect. If you want to change the color of this glass, then you can go to the fill and you can take any color. So I have taken this one. Okay friends, so that's how we can create performance meter in Microsoft Excel. I hope you have enjoyed this video, friends. I will upload this Excel file to my Google Drive and will share the link in video description box. Please download this for practice. Thank you so much for the watching.